shall cross the barren desert, but you shall not die of thirst. You shall wander far in safety, though you do not know the way. You shall speak your words to foreign men, and they will understand. You shall see the face of God and
the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Lord be with you. And we gather here this afternoon to pay our final respects to Tommy. A sad occasion, particularly for those who have to let go of him, but also an occasion of joy for Tommy as we are in the Easter season celebrating the resurrection of Jesus, which is our own final aim. So, coming together, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. Lord Jesus, you raise the dead to life in the Spirit, Lord of mercy. Lord Jesus, you bring pardon and peace to the sinner, Christ of mercy. Lord Jesus, you bring light to those in darkness. Lord, have mercy. And may Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Let us pray. O God, who through the ending of present things open up the beginning of things to come, grant, we pray, that the soul of your servant Tommy may be led by you to attain the inheritance of eternal redemption. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Amen. And now the word of God will be proclaimed for us in the readings by Drena and Brandon.
First reading, a reading from the first letter of St. John. Think of the love that the Father has lavished on us by letting us be called God's children. and that is what we are. Because the world refused to acknowledge him, therefore it does not acknowledge us. My dear people, we are already the children of God, but what we are to be in the future has not yet been revealed. All we know is that when it is revealed, we shall be like him, because we shall see him as he really is. The word of the Lord.
Second reading, a reading from the first letter of St. Paul to Thessalonians. We shall stay with the Lord forever. We want you to be quite certain, brothers and sisters, about those who have died, to make sure that you don't grieve for them, like the other people who have no hope. We believe that Jesus died and rose again, and he will be the same for those who died in Jesus. God will bring them with him. We can tell you this from the Lord's own teaching, that any of us who are left alive under the Lord, until the Lord's coming, will have no advantage over those who have died. At the trumpet of the God, the voice of the archangel will call out the command, and the Lord himself will come down from heaven. Those who have died in Christ will be the first to rise, and those of us who are still alive will be taken up into the clouds together with them to meet the Lord in the air. So we shall stay with the Lord forever. With such thoughts as these, you should comfort one another. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Please stand to proclaim the gospel.
Believes in me will never die.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Jesus said to his disciples, "When the Son of Man comes in his glory, escorted by all the angels, then he will take his seat on his throne of glory. All the nations will be assembled before him, and he will separate men one from another, as the shepherd separates sheep from goats. He will place the sheep on his right hand and the goats on his left. Then the king will say to those on his right hand, 'Come, you whom my Father has blessed, take for your heritage the kingdom prepared for you since the foundation of the world. For I was hungry, and you gave me food. I was thirsty, and you gave me drink. I was a stranger, and you made me welcome. Naked, and you clothed me. Sick, and you visited me. In prison, and you came to see me.' Then the virtuous will say to him in reply, 'Lord, when did we see you hungry and feed you, or thirsty and give you drink? When did we see you a stranger and make you welcome, naked and clothe you, sick or in prison, and go to see you?' And the king will answer, 'I tell you solemnly, insofar as you did this to one of the least of these brothers of mine, you did it to me.'" The Gospel of the Lord. Now you may be seated for a few moments. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Tommy was born and reared in Irwin Street here in the town, the son of Jimmy and Martha, one of 10 children. He was always very witty and full of mischief. On one occasion, Tommy and his best friend got into a bread van, the letter off the handbrake. It rolled down the hill and crashed into a wall. And when the police came to investigate, the pair of boys escaped by hiding in a dustbin. And how ironic that Tommy would eventually become a bin man, working for the council. There was a sort of a karma involved in all of that. It was noticed by his colleagues at work that Tommy kept going into where Yvonne worked, so they set them up on a date. And the romance blossomed, and they got married in October 1969. Initially, they lived in Carrickdale Gardens, but when Paul was born, they moved to Ballyhorn Park. After Tommy's retirement, they moved to Whitesides Hill. Tommy's pride and joy throughout all was his family. And he loved all his grandchildren. And when they were tots, he would amaze them by seemingly producing sweets and coins from behind their ears. And indeed, when his own children were growing up, he would bring them every Friday night down to Judge's shop for cake and a block of ice cream to make cake floats in pint glasses. And that's the only use that the pint glasses got, as Tommy was a lifelong pioneer. He also loved working with cars, and he had worked for a while in the Fiat garage at Anna. He was a member of the choir here in St. John's, I'm told, and he certainly loved classical music. He was a fan of Richard Tauber, Mario Lanza, and more recently, he enjoyed André Rieu. And he has a collection of classical records of which he was very protective and very proud. Indeed, after his working days on the council, he was presented with a Belfast crystal plate, which is visible at the front of our wee display here. Every single one of us came into this world as a stranger, and we were welcomed into a happy family home. And those of you mourning today will no doubt be remembering all these things. And it is the marvel of our Christian faith that these simple realities of daily living become the seed from which eternal life flowers. It is our faith that life is changed, not taken away. We believe in the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. And we thank God for the life of Tommy, which has reached its earthly fulfillment. We thank God for all we have received. And we pray that our Lord may now speak these words to Tommy. Come, you whom my Father has blessed. Take for your heritage the kingdom prepared for you since the foundation of the world. Tommy had been in hospital throughout most of the month of March, but since then he has been cared for lovingly by his family, his carers, and in recent times by the Marie Curie nurses. Last night when I was out, I was treated to a rendition of many of Tommy's funny stories. I was particularly taken by this one. Paddy had built a rocket in order to become the first man to reach the sun. His launch pad was built of wooden pallets taller than the Edenderry bonfire. And this drew the attention of the media. And at a press conference, a reporter from Sky News asked Paddy, "Have you given any thought of how you might survive the ferocious temperature of the sun?" "Oh yes," says Paddy, "we've got it all figured out. We're going to land there at night time." There are many other stories that could be told, but they're for another day. At this point, I extend my sympathy and that of Canon Toner to Yvonne, to Paul, Drena and Martin, daughters-in-law Nadean and Ella, son-in-law Stephen, the grandchildren Daniel, Aimee, Jamie, Harry, Ethan, Millie-Rose and Naoh, and his brothers, Denny and Brian, nieces, nephews, and all the family. And may he rest in peace. And now, Martina, Jamie, Stephen, Nadean, Nicola, and maybe Emma might be leading us in prayer. God, the Almighty Father, raised Christ, his Son, from the dead. With confidence, we ask him to save all his people, both living and dead.
In baptism, Tommy received the light of Christ. Scatter the darkness now and lead him over the waters of death. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Our brother Tommy was nourished at the table of the Saviour. Welcome him into the halls of the heavenly banquet. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Many friends and members of our family have gone before us and await the kingdom. Grant them everlasting home with your Son. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Those who trusted in the Lord now sleep in the Lord. Give refreshment, rest and peace to all whose faith is known to you alone. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
The family and friends of Tommy seek comfort and consolation, heal their pain and dispel their darkness and doubt that come from grief. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We are assembled here in faith and confidence to pray for our brother Tommy. Strengthen our hope so that we may live on in expectations of your son's coming. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us. Let us pray. God, our shelter and our strength, you listen in love to the cry of your people. Hear the prayers we offer for our departed brothers and sisters. Cleanse them of their sins and grant them the fullness of redemption. And we ask this through Christ our Lord.
Bring flowers of the rarest, bring blossoms the fairest, from garden and woodland and hillside and dale. Our full hearts are swelling, our glad voices telling the praise of the loveliest flower of the vale. O Mary, we crown thee with blossoms today, queen of the angels and queen of the May. O Mary, crown thee with blossoms today, queen of the angels and queen of the May.
Let us pray. Look favorably on our offerings, O Lord, so that your departed servant Tommy may be taken up into glory with your Son, in whose great mystery of love we are all united, through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In him the hope of blessed resurrection has dawned, that those saddened by the certainty of dying might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful Lord, life is changed, not ended. And when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so, with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim. Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. And once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Eamon, our Bishop, his assistant Bishop Michael, and all the clergy. Remember your servant Tommy, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that he who was united with your Son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Joseph, our venerable spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Lamb of God, behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed. For the distribution of Holy Communion, I will begin by distributing to those on my right hand middle aisle here, and the minister of the Eucharist will start over at the stations of the cross side, and when she is finished there, I will move over then to give to those on my left hand middle aisle, and the minister will then go over to the choir side. We'll just take our time.
The sun you Dominus tecum. Benedicta tu in mulieribus, et benedictus, et benedictus fructus ventris, ventris tu. Let us pray. Grant, we pray, O Lord, that your servant Tommy, for whom we have celebrated this Paschal sacrament, may pass over to a dwelling place of light and peace through Christ our Lord. I'd like to just take this opportunity to thank all who have prepared this funeral liturgy and all who have taken part by leading us in the readings, the Word of God, and in the prayers, which were all done excellently. Very well done. And I'd like to thank Anya McKee for the beautiful music, and Mark McGee for singing for us this afternoon. Before we go our separate ways, let us take leave of our brother. May our farewell express our affection for him. May it ease our sadness and strengthen our hope. One day we shall joyfully greet him again when the love of Christ, which conquers all things, destroys even death itself. Receive his soul and present him to God the Most High. Saints of God, come to his aid, hasten to meet him, angels of the Lord. May Christ, who called you, take you to himself. May angels lead you to the bosom of Abraham. Eternal rest grant unto him, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon him. Into your hands, Father of mercies, we commend our brother Tommy in the sure and certain hope that together with all who died in Christ, he will rise with him on the last day. We give you thanks for the blessings which you bestowed upon Tommy in this life. They are signs to us of your goodness and of our fellowship with the saints in Christ. Merciful Lord, turn toward us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant.
and help us who remain to comfort one another with assurances of faith until we all meet in Christ and we are with you and with our brother forever. Amen. In peace, let us take our brother Tommy to his place of rest.